Guys, this is Grace and welcome to my channel. I am sharing a new layout with you, and this is in connection with my guest design team gig over at the Scrap Room Kit Club. So this is also based off of their monthly sketch, and so we'll get on right ahead. So the products that I'm using are the Cartabella Summer Splash, which is part of the monthly kit, or the flavors of the month kit of July 2018 for the Scrap Room Kit Club. Sorry. So I'm using three by four photos here. So the Kit Club, the kit comes with two white cardstock, and I'm only using one because I'm only going to do a single page. And to further utilize this paper, I am going to mat my photos, but instead of grabbing another white cardstock, I'm just going to cut the inside of this white paper and use that for my matting. I know that we have a lot of papers, and I definitely don't need to do this, but it's just become a habit for me to actually cut the inside of my cardstocks, especially when I know that I am going to be covering up that cardstock with some patterned paper anyways. If you've been watching my videos, you know that I do this all the time with my cardstock bases. So this time I'm going to cut that flamingo paper to about 6 inch by just a little bit shy of 12 inch. And that's because I like my pages to have a little bit of border around it. And so that's what I'm gonna do. Now I am pulling out my trusty Creative Memories circle cutter with some blades, and I'm gonna cut it to create a perfect half circle. The sketch called for a circle, but I figured that I could do a half since I'm going to cover up the one side of it with some photos anyways. So the sketch also called for some thick banners on the bottom. There's actually two. One is behind the circle, and then the other one is over the circle. So I'm working on doing that right now. The sketch showed that this bigger banner has notches on both sides, but I'm just gonna do one just because it's more pleasing to my eye that way. Now there's this paper with a lot of blocks on one side and then striped paper on another, and so before I cut the stripe to where I want it, I was kind of looking at the other side to see what I can use as a block for my for part of my title. This Flavor of the Month kit also came with some die cuts, and so I was looking at maybe seeing if I could use part for my title, part block and part die cut, but I would end up not using the memories just because it has the stripe, and I was planning on putting my title right there on that circle right above the striped paper. So it was kind of there was just too much stripe going on that area, so I figured that I will scrap that idea and go for another different one. And so the title that I ended up using is that Pool Therapy, which was perfect for the layouts or the photos that I have. These are photos of just me and the family having fun at my in-laws' pool last summer when we were in California. We cannot go to California without playing in the water, and thankfully my in-laws have a pool, so we can do that for my kids anyways. They were doing it every single day. So I decided to mat that block with some more of the flamingo paper because I thought that the pinks in the paper would be able to make my block stand out a little bit more. And to further emphasize this little piece, I pulled out my very old Heidi Swap edge distresser. Raise your hand if you still have that tool. But I just wanted to have kind of a little bit of a grungy look. These papers just kind of give that feel for me, that kind of distress. The papers are really nice quality because they're pretty thick. But the elements on it kind of have that little bit of a vintagey look, and so that's why I decided to kind of distress that that edge. I'm also going to distress the circle one as well. So that's gonna have that edging as well. So now I'm just kind of playing with the rest of the elements here, trying to decide where everything's gonna go and how I'm going to kind of decorate it with those die cuts. There was a tag. I forgot what it says in the tag, but it was just a perfect color to add as a visual triangle element on the left side of my page. So I'm gonna do that, and I'm gonna distress everything now just to kind of repeat that same process and to give a unified look to all of my elements. So if you have not heard of the Scrap Room Kit Club, the their link to the shop will be in the description below. They have a Flavor of the Month kit where basically they have a little bit of sampling of some of the latest releases out there. So you don't get the whole collection. You get about 2 to 3 papers of each one, but you do get 4 samplings of I mean, 4 different collection, 4 different samplings of 4 different collections. That's what I'm trying to say. So it's really cool. This is my first time to try their kits, and I have been really inspired by them. I mean, all of these collections were new to me, and so I've never worked with any of them. And I like that they have themed elements in there so that it works perfectly for, scrapbooking some holidays. But it also has some just seasons and some collections that are for every day that would work for whatever scrapbooking that you're doing for this month. So I have highlighted some of these elements with just adding them with some foam adhesive. I use some fun foam for that. Right now I am using double-sided 1/4 inch kind of score tape. It's not the score tape brand, but it's similar to that. So that's what I've been using for my adhesive, and it's pretty good. I bought it at Amazon, and it works well. And this particular kit came with, or this particular pack came with a sampling of some enamel dots, and so I just sprinkled that all over and it worked fine. Now, I'm the kind of person that I like to have borders around my page, and usually I do that with a pattern paper, but because I was very limited with paper, that I didn't want to use a full sheet, or at least an almost full sheet of 12 by 12. So to still create that border, I used my pen to create that. And that is my page for today, and I will catch you guys on the next go around. Bye.